than the one who fails, than to adopt or copy the one who the Almighty Lord commanded our Muslim youth to adopt. Now, the question can be answered as to why they were the generation of light, as to why they were shining stars, his students, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, because they were nourished by the sap and light of their beloved teacher sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thus they attained the height of morality. They experienced firsthand the fresh revelation, descendants of the glorious uncreated word of the Almighty Lord being bestowed and thus taught by the teacher himself, acquiring an unwavering sense of responsibility. The more they were persecuted, the more faith they received. Thus, the disbelievers, looking at that, they look at them with immense jealousy, as the latter was paving their ways to the gates of hellfire. The former were achieving their palaces in paradise. Whoever loves the companions is because they love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever hates the companions, it is due to his hatred to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever abuses them, may the curse of Allah and the angels and all the faithful believers be upon this person. Who can abuse the likes of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, of Umar al-Faruq, of Uthman dhu-Nurayn, of Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abu Turab, when Muhammad sallam of Abu Bakr and Uthman and Umar was standing on the mountain of Uhud, it started to tremble underneath them. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Uskun Uhud, be calm O Uhud, innama alayka, there is indeed on you, Nabiyun, the Prophet, wa Siddiqun, Abu Bakr, a true believer, wa Shahidan, and two martyrs, Uthman, wa Umar." Who can abuse the works of Sayfullah, Khalid ibn Walid, Sayful Munsiyufillah, a sword from amongst the swords of the Almighty Lord. The likes of Bilal ibn Rabah, as Muhammad said to us all, رَأَيْتُ وَسَمِحْتُ دَفَّنَ عَلَيْكَ بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ بِالْجَنَّةِ I heard your footsteps, O Bilal, in front of me in paradise. Who can abuse those who will promise paradise? Promise paradise. The likes of Talha ibn Ubaidillah, the likes of Zubayr ibn Awwam, the likes of Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas, of Sa'id ibn Zayd, of Ukasha, of Abdurrahman ibn Awf, Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah, of Umar, his brother Sumayyah, his brother Yasir, the likes of Abdullah ibn Salam, the likes of Al-Khansa, the likes of the rest of the companions. They were steadfast, they were patient against the face of adversity. As soon as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proclaimed La ilaha illallah and condemned his people's deviation, Mecca erupted in a storm of anger. They considered these beloved men, these companions, radiallahu anhum, as outlaws and rebels. They looted their wealth, spilt their blood, violated their sanctuary, all because they said La ilaha illallah. They wanted to demoralize the Muslims, decrease and destroy their faith, obliterate, eradicate Islam. But did it work? The more they were persecuted, the more faith was increasing. Why? Because there were students of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who desired nothing in this life but to achieve the pleasure of the Almighty Lord. And thus, the onlooker, when he saw them, he was dazzled, saying, what made them the best of generations? What made them the generation of light? It was their intense love for the sake of the Almighty Lord. They responded with an immediate obedience to the commands of Allah Ta'ala. When they heard a command or prohibition, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ, we hear and obey. Oh Allah, forgive us and to you is our return. Hanbalatul Asir, a prime example. Hanbalatul Asir, at the call for the battle of Uhud. He was just a newly married man. Hayya ala al-jihad. He called, he heard the call. He was still with his wife the first night. He did not spare time for ghusl. He immediately responded to the call with obedience, didn't question it, and ran out to the battlefield where he met Sufyan. Had almost killed him, but Allah blessed him with martyrdom on the hands of Shaddad ibn al-Aswad. Muhammad witnessed after his death the angels descending on Hamdallah and performing ghusl for him. As soon as the Almighty Lord revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the evil plans, plots of Quraysh, the wicked evil conspiracies of Quraysh, and informed him that he has to take refuge in Medina, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rushed to the house of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and disclosed to him that migration to Medina has been ordered. Abu Bakr looked at him in his eyes and said, Ya Rasulullah, who will accompany you on this journey? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, You are Abu Bakr who will accompany on this journey. He stared at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, As-suhbatu ya Rasulullah, companionship, O Prophet of Allah. Fastees and tees and maltees trickled from the eyes of Abu Bakr out of joy. What a beautiful companionship. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What a beautiful companionship. And Aisha said, Wallahi, I had not seen anyone cry out of joy as I had seen Abu Bakr as-Siddiq on that day cry out of joy. Now today, when you hear an obligation or prohibition, you see people close or lower their heads, close their ears if it does not suit their desire. Immediately, when they hear that a command or prohibition, they lower their head, close their ears, close their eyes if it does not suit their desire. Wallahi, this is the mentality of the infidels. This is the path of infidelity, of kufr. Where's sami'na wa ata'na? Where's the generation of light? Where's the examples of Hamdallah, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq? Brothers and sisters, the path to hellfire is a slippery downhill slope. Yes, it looks attractive, promising eternal salvation or instant satisfaction. It makes you feel good as though a drug addict feels good when he's on a high. But oblivious of the ruin that awaits him. This is the path of materialism, consumerism, the path of evil, which promises liberation from all obligations of higher authority, making you the slave of your own desire, thus leading you to eternal doom and eternal gloom. Brothers and sisters, when you hear the call of Islam, a prohibition, or command, be like the generation of light. Be like Hamdallah. Sami'na wa ata'na ghufranaka rabbana wa ilayka al-masir. We hear of Allah, we obey of Allah. To give us of Allah and to you is indeed our return. This is the Muslim. This is the generation of light. They were firm in their belief, with full conviction to stick to the truth and not waver. A prime example is the situation of Bilal. When he embraced Islam, Umayyah, that cruel, evil, wicked master of his, came to Bilal and said, You are nothing, O Bilal, but a slave. From the top of your peppercorn head to the bottom of your crow feet, he said to him, The day I bought you, I bought your soul and your mind for your disobedience. What was his disobedience? Saying, La ilaha illallah. I shall make you taste the punishment until all the foolish beliefs are removed from your thick skull. After they punished Bilal, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Umayyah came up to him and said, I hope today's punishment has taught you a lesson. Bilal, locking his stare into his cruel master's eyes, he said to him, Your whips might have cut my flesh to ribbons, but my faith in the one true God will never ever waver. Never ever waver.